I always wanted to think that I was an alien. I used to think when I was young that I was adopted by my mother because they found me and a spaceship let me off. I was from a different planet. I wanted to be from a different planet really bad. And every night I used to talk to my real parents and my real family in the skies. I knew that there were thousands of other alien babies dropped off. And they're all over the place, and I've met quite a few of them. It's just something that I've always liked to toy with in my mind. It was really fun to pretend that, you know. There's some special reason for me to be here, and I feel really homesick all the time, and so do the other aliens. And I only have a chance to come across like a handful of other aliens throughout the rest of my life. Eventually, one day, we'll find out what we're supposed to do.
I was spanked all the time. My dad would, in my social situations when we're at restaurants or something, if I had spilled a glass of water or something, he'd get me in a headlock and dig his knuckles into my head or smack me in the face. I never understood that, why a parent would be so embarrassed or so intimidated by what other people would think of you in a restaurant just because your child spilled something on accident, to have to punish them for having an accident. That's a weird psychological trick to play on a child, because I still put myself down and cuss myself out for knocking things over. I get really upset with myself because I've been conditioned to not spill things. Don't have accidents, don't have human error. Everything's supposed to be perfect at all times, you know. Fuck him for that.
A tally man at Mayer Brothers Wood Mill. So basically he just walked around all day and counted logs. His idea of father and son day out would be to take me to work on Saturdays and Sundays, and I would sit in his office while he went and counted logs. It was like a quite exciting weekend. I've never felt like I've really had a father, you know? I've never had a father figure who I could share things with, and it's hard to remember anything up until I was 7 years old, and that was the time that I was actually living with him, and he was my dad, and I had a mother and father, and after that, I lived with him for a short time, and then he got married, and after that, I was, you know, like one of the last things of importance on his list. If it was me, if I was in that situation with Courtney and Francis, I still, for the rest of my life, would go out of my way to try to contact Francis and try to have a relationship with her and share things with her, you know, and he just gave up.
Something's not right.
somehow the way that our parents were brought up isn't the way it's supposed to be. They fucked up somehow. They're living in a fantasy world, so they must have done something wrong. They got a divorce. They had to sow their oats, just like my mom did. You know, they had to start drinking when they were 30, and really confused and going and fucking up over and over again with raising their children as teenagers because they don't understand the things that those kids need. I mean, I remember all my friends asking that same question, like 7 years old, and it's really a necessary time to be asking that, you know? But it was just a plague. It was a total disease. After that, I started to realize that people were looking at me even more peculiarly than usual. And then I started to get harassed by some of the people, especially in gym class. They felt threatened because they were naked and I was supposedly gay, so they'd either better cover up their penises or punch me, or both. But then after that, I started being proud of the fact that I was gay, even though I wasn't. I really enjoyed the conflict. Pretty excited because I almost found my identity. I was a special